Hello students, welcome to the series on marketing and retail business. Today we are going to study retail management. In this we will cover unit 4 and we are going to study the strategic framework for value creation through CRM in retail industry. Now let's study the objective of this lecture. The objective of this lecture is to study the strategic framework for CRM and we will focus on value creation in retail industry. Now let's study the challenges of CRM systems in market. The companies face large challenges when trying to implement CRM systems. Consumer companies may not effectively use their connections with the customers due to misunderstandings or misinterpretations of CRM systems analysis. Now because this system is advanced, developed and an asset for company, but still a huge data and large information is also facing or posing problems for users and analysts. The problem is that when you have data, how do we use this data for our basic purpose? The misinterpretation of data and the misunderstanding of consumers' perceptions in market can also create problems for manufacturers and for company analysts. Consumers may be searching many things, but maybe in actual life actually they are going to use these things is still a kind of a question and a challenge for many companies. There is lack of customized relationships. Client who want to be treated more like a friend may be treated like just a party for exchange. Lack of a bridge between input data in a CRM system analysis and analysis output is a problem. Now companies when they have the data are still also not able to manage customize in a friendly relationship with the customer because the electronic media is not helping them to cultivate a kind of a friendship. The value of interaction and the value of meetings is still important in most of the businesses which are related to the fashion and the high need customized services given to the customers. So when you have designer products into the market, still the customers want a friendly and a confident relationship that they will be handled in a proper way by a designer. Second is what is the input data and what you want to give. The coordination is not done in a proper way. So customization and coordination is a bigger challenge for companies. And when the data is available, you are not able to handle and look into the details of the customer queries in a systematic way. Companies are not able to gain a feasible plan. Many studies show that customers are frequently frustrated by a company's inability to meet their relationship expectations. Companies do not always know how to translate the data they have gained from CRM software into a feasible plan of action. Now see, the data is enough with many websites. There are companies who have overnight become successful like Flipkart, or you have Snapdeal or many companies, but still these companies also have frustrated and unsatisfied customers who generally have faced problems or who generally have kind of orders which are not according to their needs or according to the quality required by them. So it's not very essential that if you have data you are able to handle people, because large data is also posing great problems for companies, is how to reach to the customers, how to handle on a segmented basis and how to give customized solutions to each and everybody is also becoming a big end problem for many big companies who have large source of customers on their websites. The corporations are built on fragmented basis. Many corporations only use CRM systems on a partial or fragmented basis. Now, companies do have data, but they are not using the total data input to frame their strategic framework, because even they don't have the resources to reach and to meet to the need of every customer. Even companies like Amazon, they are not able to give you customized solutions to your problems. Most of the deals which are given by customers may satisfy customers, but sometimes you have wrong sellers on Amazon's website who basically are not very conscious about the quality. The rating system is there, but still it makes customer to go and get the complaints managed not in a proper way, which tries to give a system which is not so satisfying to the customers also, because many vendors on the Amazon also don't have a proper credit agency to rank them. So this is basically a free ranking agencies or free customer from all over the world cannot rank sellers. The sellers need to be listed somewhere, and after the listing and approved by certain bodies, then only they should be listed on most of the companies. Otherwise, they are not able to give you the quality as desired by the customers. Sometimes the customers don't buy from these websites because we are not very sure about their quality of the products given. It is difficult for staff to get used to the CRM systems. The senior executives report that their biggest challenge is to get the staff used to the systems which they can install. Customer preferences may increase the adoption of CRM among the developing countries. The staff of many companies is not used to handle the system of using the softwares. So, to give them training becomes a difficult part on the company. People are not able to segregate the data and use according to their ability and the capability to put data in a systematic way to understand the preferences. So, this is posing a lot of problem for companies to get technical people who can handle data in a better way. The strategic inputs for CRM system is to capture social networks. The system tries to capture the data from social networking traffic like Twitter handles, Facebook page addresses and the online social networking sites. These are discussed and the solutions are provided that would help in bringing more clientele. Now, you are collecting fragmented data from Twitter or you are collecting data from Facebook. The Twitter data becomes important for publication magazines, like most of the magazines which are giving education and value to the students and the customers are writing about the latest trends. Even the market promotion companies and the advertising companies are studying the frustrations of the customers, and this is a good literature available on Twitter, which are basically used by people in the industry to design creative ads, and also used by many media magazines to give solutions to people's frustration. CRM vendors can offer subscription to build quality of services. Many CRM vendors offer subscription based web tools like cloud computing and SaaS. So, vendors of CRM now have started giving you cloud computing services where you can store data in an open cloud where you can access information from any place at any time and any country irrespective of zone and time. Acquisition of cloud based markets. Traditional providers have recently moved into a cloud based market via acquisition of small providers. Now, if you want to enter into this vast global market, it is very difficult for companies to directly get into the other market or zone, because to collect the data would take years. So, they try to acquire small service providers who are already in business. The takeover of these providers basically gives them a set of users, which is basically adding business to their site. Like YouTube initially was working as an independent company, but because of the popularity and its usage and its impact on society, Google took over this company, and the database of YouTube now is acquired by Google. So, this gives a vast increase of a particular class of customers who are basically used to the videos and audio systems. So, Google had an additional advantage of increased customer base because this customer base was already built up by a smaller company. So, to collect this data would take many years, but acquisitions would increase your basic resource in terms of power in the market. Use of social media for better CRM strategy. The era of the social customer refers to the use of social media, Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Google, Pinterest, Instagram, and the customer reviews given by customers on Amazon. The CRM philosophy and strategy has shifted to encompass social networks and user communities. Now, the CRM strategy basically needs to look into the preferences and the data collected on Twitter or on Facebook, Insta, because this basically gives you the network of the communities who are using particular services, and these particular services are community based. Like a social strategy can look better to a market in terms where you relate to a community of NGOs who are working into a particular problem of water conservation or women empowerment. So, the database of the communities which is built up and collected over the years on the social network is giving a kind of a agenda and a power to many companies through the CRMs to collect and get into that resource so as to design their presence in the market. Empowering sales team can build better CRM analysis. Salesforce also play an important role in CRM as maximizing sales effectiveness and increasing sales productivity is a driving force behind the adoption of CRM. Empowering sales managers can create effective CRM systems. Now, your CRM systems can work effectively if the company has trained people in the industry. These trained people can be adapted to the system in such a way that they can use the analysis to the benefit of the companies. The staff has to be technical and the staff has to be trained so as to respond to the data in a coordinated way and to design the program according to the basic input which is available with the company. Communication through sales managers. The productivity of any organization can increase through effective communication through symmetric CRM systems by customizing relationships. So, these CRM systems can also increase the customized and one-to-one relationship with the customers. That is basically the organizations can connect to the customers in a detailed and in an elaborative way. Effective vendor relationship management can enhance customer satisfaction. Another related development is vendor relationship management, that is the VRM, which is providing tools and services that allow customers to manage their individual relationships with the vendors. Now, who are vendors in the market? The vendors are the suppliers. The suppliers also have a database of the products and services which are useful to many manufacturers all over the world. The global integration of suppliers on websites like Alibaba and IndiaMart is putting a database for all people who want to design innovative products and services in the market. So, this data can enhance the customer satisfaction and even the customer according to his needs can look into the services which are available on these websites. So, they can calculate the cost and the price which they can afford in the market. The manufacturer and the vendor have a relationship, but this relationship becomes transparent when the customers are also able to see the rates and the value of services given on the websites of any manufacturer or the vendor. So, they know what is the kind of the systematic coordination to build a package in a successful way. Building Salesforce automation. The companies need to invest in Salesforce automation, that is SFA. They need third or fourth generation implementation. That is, now the companies need to build Salesforce automation, a kind of a basic software which gives you the autonomy of generally giving good training to the Salesforce so that they can effectively connect to the company's database of services given by the call centers. The Salesforce automation through the companies can enhance value of people to connect with the customers in a systematic and coordinated way where the account history is stored and the total knowledge of the customer is on the website. You can study the knowledge and the information about the customer and according to his history you can communicate to the customer. So, the Salesforce automation has advantage of having a data by which they can understand the preferences. Building extended relationship management. Extended relationship management is the ERM. Lenny defines ERM as extending CRM disciplines to secondary allies such as government, press and industry consortia. So, what is relationship management is not only with the customer, it has to be extended relationship with press, government and industry cartels, that is what is the industry associations from where the trends are being generated. So, if you have a positive relationship with government and with the press and with the industry consortia, obviously a credibility is increased which carries a better trust in the minds of the customers in a systematic way. Creating customer transparency. The push CRM towards a customer transparency CT model has increased the impact of channel devices and social media. So, when we have designed these model, that is the CT model. CT model is the customer transparency, that is whatever you are giving, what kind of service, what kind of value, and you are also taking the review of the service which you have given. That basically increases the honesty of the company to reflect where they are going wrong, where they are able to not satisfy the customer, and where they are able to satisfy the customer is the niche and the competitive advantage which they are able to build in the company. And this is the specialized segment where they are more trained to give their presence in the market. Building customer success teams. The customer success can be created by building trained and professional teams for managing customer relations. Now, the new concept of customer success team is that you have core people in the company who are very trained in terms of managing negotiations with the company. These people basically handle customers in a different way. You have Salesforce which does the routine work, but the sales team who look into the success of managing relationships try to design innovative and creative programs for entertaining customers through the games or through the marketing, advertising or through the promotions, which are now very lucrative for people to connect with. Like Patanjali basically built its success through the advertising given on the video games. So these video games basically were a kind of a basic attraction for the customers, and through these games they had to collect points by which the product reached to a deeper segment of the customers. Understanding customer health. The customer health can be managed by enhancing additional capabilities for holistic understanding of customer health. The existing vendors have better power of customized relations as compared to new entrants. Now, the capabilities are basically collected over the years. The capability of a database of a customer is the power given to the company. Now, when Facebook has emerged, it has emerged not only as a corporation but as a country which is larger than many countries of the world. So Facebook may be not a marketing tool for many companies, because companies have shifted to many other applications and many other social media, but still Facebook is a directory to find addresses and to connect with people, friends and families. So still maybe you have other communication areas in terms of Insta and WhatsApp where you can connect, but still Facebook has a capability of having data of many people who have a kind of a presence on this media for search of addresses and contacts. Increased impact of channels. Denison D. Greger in 2011 describes the shift from a push CRM towards a customer transparency CT model due to the increased impact of channel devices and social media. So this author basically in 2011, that is D. Greger, basically defined CT, that is the customer transparency model, is a better solution to work in market, because your presence is basically designed and impacted on devices like Twitter or social media or any other social community where you are connected to. Building customer success. More and more companies establish customer success teams as separate from the traditional sales team and task them with the managing of existing customer relationship with technical ethical advice to build faith in the minds of the customers. So you have success teams, that is the trained people. You have routine sales team who look into the traditional functions of customer management in terms of acquisition and contact and finding and giving them solutions. You have trained people, which is a kind of a separate team who looks into the innovative aspects of designing creative relations with the customers. Make CRM software easy to use for employees. CRM design and customized CRM with the end users has to be done for employees also. Employees, they are the face of the company for projecting the image in the minds of the customers. So the CRM design has to be customized also according to the employees. The employees need to use the CRM systems in a coordinated way. So they also need to understand the system. So the familiarity of the software with the end user like employer is also important. The employer and the employee if they understand the software, can connect to the customers in a better way. Track customer behavior throughout the sales cycle. Before the sales call, gather data about the prospect on social media and identify what type of information they share across the channel. Sales representative should keep track of which content resonates the most. Now, when you try to call a customer, you basically have to study and do a kind of a research about the customer. Who is the customer? What is his country of origin? What is his address? We have almost record of all the customers on the company websites or on the social media. Before contacting the customer, it is important to track the behavior, where he is spending, where he is going. And after having a preliminary information about the customer, we can make a call so as to give him the respect of understanding and communicating according to his areas of interest. CRM needs to improve business processes. The strategic integration of customer data from across different business systems can produce a highly personalized and even predictive marketing and sales approach. Now, what is strategic integration? That is, we need to increase the process implementation and integration in such a way that the data is shared across all the channels and across all the fronts of the company. We need to give personalized information to the customers through an easy tracking system. This basically is a kind of a impact which needs to be designed through the processes which are simple and systematic. CRM synchronization is important. CRM needs automatic synchronization with calendar and import of client-based meetings to build business-to-business automation softwares. We need to synchronize the data, because if the synchronization is done, the automation of knowing the customer can be done in an easy way. This automation would allow you to read the customer's data in a easy way, because now the classification and a kind of a important reading of the customer analysis is done through diagrams, which can, that is the bar charts and the pie charts, which can help you to understand the preferences of his purchase in all the segments and his lifestyle. Keep data up to date. It is critical to have consistent process for updating and managing customer data. The sales representative need to enter customer information by providing an easy to use application to create accurate data. Now, to collect data, to systemize it and to put it into company's database basically is difficult. So now most of the companies, if they want to enter the name, address, the preference, the age, the area, it becomes difficult and it is time consuming. But now companies have designed softwares by which they can connect to the Aadhaar, that is the KYC coordination, synchronization of CRM with this is easy uploading of information from anywhere at any time. So when we are trying to design applications through CRM which are connecting to the KYC options, is basically to take the data from Aadhaar and put it on your website. That is, you can easily have access and information from the other sources. Otherwise, you have to feed the data, would take a long time. Now, like take the example when Jio SIMs were selling, they were not feeding the entire data of the customer. They were only taking the Aadhaar number by which they had the access to that number. And that unique identity basically gave you access to all the information available to the company. So this was an easy way to collect the address, the information, the age, the basic identity of the customer could be easily uploaded on the websites. Now, mobilize cloud-based CRM. The cloud-based CRM that offers mobile capabilities allows users to keep track of customer interactions and manage leads, proposals, opportunities, projects and files from any device at any time. For companies with employees that are constantly in and out of the office, this can improve effectiveness and productivity. Now, CRM systems need to be cloud-based. Cloud-based mobilization of resources is important so as to avail data information to all the customers from any place at any time through any device. So whatever device you are using, you just have to log in to collect your information and data. So most of the services should be presented on those platforms of cloud where the customers can avail your resources. Now let's study the summary of this lecture. In this lecture, we have studied the strategic framework for creating value through CRM systems. CRM systems are important for the customers, the data collected and the data segregate offers a valuable resource to the company by which they can frame the communication, the intelligence and the strategies to connect with the customers. This database for companies is becoming important to design the marketing and the business intelligence systems by which they are able to increase their sales. I hope the students must have understood the strategic inputs for enhancing the value of CRM for the customers. Thank you, students.